Lack of alternatives to firewood and charcoal is halting efforts aimed at addressing deforestation in the country. This follows a continued debate on a link between urban demand for charcoal and depletion of forests in Malawi between charcoal vendors and environmental conservation activists. Bernard Gankoma has compiled this report, read by Arthur Chokoto.
Nearly 97% households in Malawi rely on firewood or charcoal as their primary source of cooking and heating fuel. This is according to a 2017 to 2027 National Charcoal Strategy. The revelations also mean that demand for charcoal and firewood is contributing to deforestation in Malawi. According to Isaac Kaluzi, a charcoal trader, it is difficult for Malawi to switch from charcoal to other renewable energy sources like biogas and solar, as the sources are expensive for ordinary Malawians.
I am aware that forests are being depleted as a result of charcoal making. It is really hard for a villager to switch to those clean sources of energy which are being advocated. Take, for example, someone from Ngona. Can he afford to buy a gas stove and sustain it? Let's be realistic. We use charcoal and firewood because we are poor.
However, the director of energy in the Ministry of Energy, Cassius Chwambo, says the ministry is making progress to ensure that there is universal electricity for all Malawians by 2030.
As a ministry, what we are doing is we are teaching these people to say, if you want energy, okay, from gas, this is how you can deal as a gas supplier or a dealer generally, and this is how myself as an end user can use that particular gas without damaging my own home, my own environment, but at the end of the day, making sure that I'm getting that clean, cheap energy source.
In the meantime, the country's forests will continue to face a massive plunder of its trees unless the goal of achieving universal electricity for every citizen is attained by 2030.
The First Lady, Madame Monica Chakwera, has spoken of the need for collective action in ending sexual abuses against girls in the country. Madame Chakwera made the remarks in Ponela, Doha, when she officially opened a safe home for abused children. Robert Kalindiza reports.
The Beni dance was part of the activities marking the official opening of the safe home. It is meant for educating and counseling girls that have been traumatized due to different forms of abuse, including defilement, courtesy of a group called When They Sent. In her remarks, when she graced the occasion, Her Excellency Madame Monica Chakwera said it is the duty of every well-meaning Malawian to stamp out any form of abuse against children and the girl child in particular. She added, with concerted efforts, it is possible to have a Malawi where every child goes a safe home to live in.
They should not be afraid to speak up and live in fear of the abuser.